Welcome to Whisky.com, where fine spirits meet. My name is Lüning, Horst Lüning, and I'm the master taster of Whisky.com. And today we have a brand new bottle here on my cask. It's a Glen Moray Classic. Oops, whenever you hear classic. It's a whiskey without an age statement on it. And always you hear classic, legacy, and so on, back to the roots. But all it is it's a no-age whiskey, and it tries to inherit from the own legacy. You hear a critical noise? Yes, you do. Glen Moray was formerly a part of the Glenmorangie PLC company, which owned Glenmorangie, Ardbeg, and Glen Moray. And then the company sold itself to Louis Vuitton Moët Hennessy, the alcoholic part, the Moët Hennessy branch of the company. And this company said, well, Glen Moray isn't that good for our portfolio of luxury goods, so we sell it. And they sold it to a French company. Oh, I do not remember the name very well. La Martinique, something like that. The Glen Moray was sold several years over the supermarkets, was always a cheap one. And so is this one. It's below 20 euros. For a standard bottle, this is quite cheap. The company is not that old. It's from the 19th century, from the very late 19th century. It's 1897. And the distillery sits on the banks of the River Lossy in Elgin. It's a dark black one. And the River Lossy, several years ago, I think in 2010, 2009, there had been a big flooding of the Lossy in Elgin, and the whole distillery was flooded. It was awful. So sitting at the riverside isn't always that good. Yeah. But you need the water for the cooling of the stills. Better sitting up the river than in the lower parts, because in the lower parts you might have this flooding, and in the upper parts the water goes fast. Yeah. Very fruity. Light. Citrus notes. A little maltiness. Quite pleasant. Grass. No, not that grass. Lawn grass. And it's officially said citrus curd cheese. No. I'm missing the proteins. Yeah. Have a sip. Still quite light, but now there's an attack of the oak. It's quite bitter in the aftertaste. And where does this bitterness come from? It's really light, and it is probably colored. There's no remark of uncolored on this bottle. And it's young, there's no age statement on it. Where does this oakiness come from? A little lemongrass. Currants, a little sour, but turning a little bit into sweetness. No, not sweetness, in less sourness. This bitterness is still there, but it's fading quite fast. So this is an unusual whiskey, quite pleasant in the nose, pleasant in the taste, and then you have this bitterness in the aftertaste. Little butterscotch. Perhaps you have another one to fully find out what this whiskey is all about. Yeah, Thank you for watching Whisky.com. Feel free to share this video with your friends. And thank you for watching.